What's up, Dennis? What's up, Fish in the Backwoods? What's up, everybody? Set off your bike? No, I don't have a bike. So. That'd be nice if it was off my bike. So that's all I do. That's all I do on this channel is just paint my own stuff. You know. Who's ever heard of clients or customers? I don't get those. I don't know what that is. And I'm having a chelada today, just wrapping up the week. And we had a pretty good week today. We had a pretty good week this week. So I'm just wrapping up the week with a chelada and some airbrushing. I was just wondering, damn, man. Well, I was just answering, damn, man. This guy. Cool. Turn down the pressure. Bike life or no life? Answer received. Yeah, I don't have a bike, so I can't be there right with you. You know, like, yeah, bike life, because I don't have a bike. So, I'm just the artist that paints the bikes and makes them look, you know, amazing. What do I know about bikes? Nothing. I know nothing about bikes. What's up, Todd? How's it going? Mr. Todd? What is this? Every now and then you get bored. You get bored? Like a 2x4? Or like a plywood? Oh, and Air Todd is here, the Skull. The original Skull Master. Dennis is hiding. Oak. I like oak. Oak is a nice, sturdy, you know, wood. I like it. Hola, Rafa. If you don't know wood, that's hard. That's what she said. Hola, Alberto. Saludos. She wants Dumbo's mom holding him in the trunk. What's up, James? How's it going? What? No way. Get out of here. Get out of here. Don't be inviting me. Go. Go play, please. Thank you. Crazy monster. Freehand abstract Aztec art. Hey, there's nothing wrong with being the Picasso of fucking Aztec art, bro. Like, you could be onto something new there, you know? You never know. You never know. Does it make you more mad if I do this? And it's like, it's smaller than my hand? How about let's zoom in so you can see even better. Bro, here. Oh, man. That question will be... I have to go bring the dogs in, guys. I totally forgot I left them out. Oh, man. I hope they're not all dirty. Ah, that's why I hate leaving them out there. One sec. Let me go get the dogs inside. Look on the screen. What's up, George? Right now, I'd say the mix is about 3-1. Like 3 parts reducer, 1 part paint. Mixed up, a little this, a little that, yep. Cheers. What's up, Pasaro? Hey, you're welcome. Good luck. I hope that one question and all of a sudden you airbrush amazing. Thanks for dropping in and good luck. There's a reason I'm a top fan and a smartass. Yeah. There's the emoji head. Oh, I don't see it. I don't know. Virgin sacrifice? No. This is when, what's his name, found his wife slain. Found the queen slain. I forget the exact story of this, but it's supposed to be significant somehow. the tongue sticking out. Did it taste like chicken? What are you talking about, bro? What kind of a snack? What? Okay. What did it taste like then? Oof. Oh, dang, I got a Charlie horse. Oh, man. Oh, what's up, Nicholas? Oh, shit. Oh. Every time I'm up and off my knees all day long, like I was this morning. The Skull Squad members seen the little Honda I did some lettering on pretty much overnight. Yeah, I was up and down off my knees a whole lot. Oof, it's really starting to kick in now. Awesome doing figures, I suppose. Oh, what is all this stuff? Are those chips in the paint, or did I do that? I think I. if I do mess up, I won't say it. Yeah, I will. I'll usually, if I mess up, I'll go, oops, really loud. It looks so easy, but it's not. It is, bro. All you gotta do is just move your finger around. That's all you gotta do. Just move your finger around. That's all I'm doing, just moving my finger around. Magic finger. What's up, Kimberly? A little bit bigger than my hand. Two hands. It's like two hands. Thank you. This is his motorcycle. Oh yeah, you'll see me riding this out there tomorrow, dude. What up, Justice? Them skulls, oh boy. I mean, you're right, dude. This is my motorcycle, and this is also my first motorcycle I've ever painted. Ever in my life. That's why the daughter is partly painted.
Ah, that's funny.
Were you scared shit on your first bike? No. Not really, it didn't really. Didn't really faze me. I had already been doing t-shirts for quite a while by then, so.
You would be scared to do a bike, you feel scared doing shirts?
I don't know, I don't know.
Scared is usually not a feeling I get while painting.
I just always remember Bob Ross, you know. And you'd be like, oh, you make it a little accident, you turn it into a happy little mistake. You know? It was meant to happen.
Repenting on the end also? Maybe. I don't know. We'll see how long I go today. Like I said, I'm just wrapping up the week. I literally have all of next week to finish this bike. So I'm already ahead of schedule on this bike. Right now, I don't have anything else, and I'm delaying everybody, so there's already another 300, a Chrysler 300, another one. Ron's wife is getting her car done, so I've put him off until after the first, because the stuff for the garage shows up on the 29th. So I need the garage empty by the 29th, which means this bike I plan to have done by the 28th, completely cleared and ready to get out the door. That's also when the mechanic will be ready for it, which needs electrical work, like I said. I'm just delaying him until then. And there's another bike already that wants to get in, but again, that's going to be delayed for a while. And I did manage to get that quick lettering car. Some quick lettering on a Honda done this morning. Which just helps, you know, that's why I'm having a chelada today. So we had, not only was it a quick, easy money today, but also a really good week, an end to a really good week. Next week, you know, we got this bike planned to finish out. I'll probably do a couple art streams for, you know, just regular stuff for myself. Yes? Go play. And then once we have the garage done, get that all set up. And then we're back in business and trucking again. Getting the garage set up should only take about a day or two. So, don't expect too much of a delay. But the stuff gets here on the 29th. So we probably won't stream on the 29th and then the 30th. And probably be back on the 1st or the 2nd. The 1st or the 2nd. Around there, probably for sure on the 3rd. We'll be back in business and rolling and streaming outside. Set up an air conditioner out there. Won't it be hot out in the garage? Yeah, I already have an AC set up. Actually, this AC has been set up since last year. I just made sure to clean it out and get it ready, you know. And I was almost gonna open stuff up back for tattoos again. People keep asking about the tattoos. I don't know. It seems like the... the whole virus thing is kind of not going away, so I'm not really in a rush to do tattoos. I know a lot of other artists, you know, chomping at the bit to get back to tattoos. I'm not one of those guys. I can wait. I ain't trying to get myself sick or my family sick or customers sick or anything like that. And to me, it's just better to just wait. Especially since we have Dennis in the chat that has like first-hand experience with the coronavirus. You know, I'm not trying to yeah, it's not like I can't just paint, you know, keep painting. And luckily, we've been really busy painting, so I'm not worried about the tattoos. It can wait. To me, it's just not worth putting my health at risk. I can wait. One tattoo is not gonna make or break the bank. Two tattoos, even 4 weeks, 5 weeks, 2 months, 5 months worth of tattoos. I still think I'd be all right because I'm painting, you know? As long as I keep painting, I'm good. If you're not good at painting, if you're not fast, then I could see it being a struggle. Because in order to make money, you gotta push stuff out the door. I think a lot of artists like tattoos too, because I hate accusing anybody of anything, but a lot of them like milking customers for session after session on a tattoo. Can't really do that on a motorcycle. Once you agree on a price, that's it. You can't be like, oh, like, I'm tired, you know, maybe you could come back in a week. Yeah. You know, I know that is because I get the customers that come and tell me, yeah, I went and got a tattoo here, and then, you know, first he started taking smoke break after smoke break, and then he's like, after a couple hours, you know, I was just looking at my tattoo finished, and then he tells me that his hand is tired and he can't continue. Then when I went back to have him finish it, you know, he said it would be another $200, and his time is not free, even though I had already paid him what we agreed on. But now I have an unfinished tattoo, so I have to finish my tattoo. How many of you has that happened to? I hear that same story played out by different people so many times. He said that's a weak ass tattoo artist. Yeah. Sadly though, you get people that go along with it. That's what gets me. Then that's how you get them stories and them tattoos. This tattoo cost me, you know, $1,500. I had to go back 8 times for 8 sessions and then I know real artists, you know, good artists out there who be doing like incredible pieces in one day and they be charging like, you know, reasonable prices. My tattoo artists were hot and we became lovers for a while. Oh my gosh. That's hilarious. There's that. And we'll just leave that kind of. It's a lot brighter in the camera than it is in person, but we'll leave that darkened in on the back like stone. That looks pretty good. Sounds like Kimberly had a good college years. She was doing things. So yeah, I think I'm gonna just do that for now. We'll leave that. I probably not tomorrow, but maybe Monday. We'll come back. We'll do these backs and then the oil pan covers, so we can knock all those out on Monday. I like how Kimberly's mighty proud of her college. Like, yes, I was. Hell yeah. No regrets. I like it. Tika. Catch your pet something, you say your name, and she looks over with the most guilty face like she knows. Alright, there you go. A lot of beautiful men in art college. Guy's ears are ringing right now. Who's talking about me? I dig it though. I wish I could have gone to art college. Sounds amazing. You know, it sounds very nice. Alright, so let me pull up the next picture for this side here. Dennis. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, Kimberly, you're giving us all the inside scoop. That airbrush room must have been smelling real nice. The smell of paint and, you know. Give me 1 sec, let me go get myself another drink. What's up, monster? What do you need? It had good ventilation. I like how you're like, no hanky panky, but you know it had good ventilation. I'm just playing. No, that's cool. Yeah, I never had a chance to go to art college, so. And yeah, that's about all I got to say about that. It was pricey, I bet. I bet it is. Dennis. They were so much great teachers that all were in business. Yeah, that sounds cool. You're just making me more and more jealous, you know what I'm saying? I don't know what part of I wish I could have gone to art school. You did it here, but I wish I could have gone to art school. It sounds so amazing. It sounds like it would have changed my life. You know, considering I have all this talent already, you know, going to art school would have been like something I would have dreamed about. Somehow an opportunity that was never given to me. We still made it happen though, we still made it happen. They can't stop my shine. I shine too bright. You could actually go as a teacher, because I'm amazing. Yeah. How do I sign up for that job? Who do I gotta talk to make that happen? I'm down. Like, look what I imagine, what I accomplish on YouTube, right? Just look at what I accomplish on YouTube with a budget of basically $0. Now imagine if I was getting paid to teach. Because I would probably still be painting motorcycles and stuff on the side, you know. But if I knew for 4 hours or 6 hours a day, I could go in somewhere and get paid to teach. The students that would come out of that would probably be amazing. Because then I could give an effort and buy supplies and not be so worried about it. I'd be okay with taking a pay cut. Even if I had to stop airbrushing on the side, as long as the money was steady. It's again, the opportunities, my guy. The opportunity of that. Where do I have to live to get that job? Also, there are some with papers, and then there's the ones with talent. Mike likes, I want to check the ventilation. Yeah, bro, I want to see what kind of ventilation's in there. That would be kind of crazy though. Being that guy teaching in college. I'd make sure to start every semester by making every single student look up and do a report on a working artist. An artist out there with some kind of a shop. Because history is great, but I think it'd be nice to focus on the present sometimes, man. There's a lot of great artists out there. I get no recognition. Like, put me to the side. I mean, there's just a lot of great artists out there. When it comes to the actual art side of what they make, there's some crazy, amazing talent. But I want, you know, the working artists. There's artists out there working every day, painting t-shirts, droning on way on, you know, stuff. Maybe those guys might feel a little good, you know, give them a little light. And study of how those guys are producing art and staying afloat, you know. 30 hoses hanging from the ceiling. Holy wow. Oh my gosh, Dennis. Going the whole nine. Dennis, you're not allowed to be a teacher, bro. You're not allowed. You're banned. Banned from the teaching department. And that, Dennis, is how we end up with a whole bunch of people with degrees that don't know how to do shit.
Wingstop can't be rude. Right on, Dennis. Enjoy your food, man. What's up, Dart? What's up, Victor? She said, check my eye rolling. Oh, boy! Boy! You better go score yourself some brownie points before you get fired from home, bro. Time to do some foot rubs or something.
Oh, the family priest. What the hell is a family priest? What does that even mean? A family priest. I would A, not trust that man around my kids, and B, not trust him around my wife. Fuck that noise. So they have one priest that does it all, huh? That's cool. I think. The quinceañeras and baptisms, huh? Is that the... Are you guys married? Like the priest that married you? Oh, okay, for the mom. Alright, yeah, alright, cool, I got you. My bad. I keep forgetting, bro, I'm not gonna lie. I don't mean to be insensitive, I just... Kimberly. Oh, in Michigan, nobody pays for art? What? What? To be fair, I don't know any artist either. Not even on Facebook. I mean, I know, I guess, the people in the chat. I don't really know them, but like, we know of each other. You know, and we all try to help each other out. The Discord is the place where we've been, you know, We've all been kind of having talks. Yeah, but like, I don't know any artists in real life anyway. So don't feel bad. I used to work alongside other artists, but that was almost a decade ago now. My ass came to Colorado to settle down. Here I am. Lame there. I don't know. I've never been to Michigan, so I don't know. That's good, Dennis, man. That's all I try to do is keep it smiling, keep it interesting around here. A special misunderstood breed for sure. Are you one of those I hate people? Do you say that a lot? I say that a lot sometimes. I fucking hate people. People are so stupid. I say it all the time. Not at a person, right? Because individuals are pretty smart. People as a whole are pretty fucking stupid. Yeah, that is me all the way. I am definitely in I hate people. What's up, New Wave Shane? You're surrounded by animals. That's how it feels. That is actually the best description. I mean, to be fair though, I can be quite the animal myself. But compared to other people, god damn it. Like, just god damn it. I just, what me and Jess were talking about this the other day, about how that law, that no child gets left behind law, and how that ended up fucking everybody in the long run. Because now we have a whole bunch of stupid people running around thinking they accomplished something when they didn't accomplish something. We literally just, we said, hey, we can't be mean to you. We gotta include you in the, so here you go, you graduated. And it's just like, oh shit. Now we got all those people. Some of them have management positions and shit, and it's just like, what the fuck is going on, my guy? This is not supposed to happen. It's like that movie Idiocracy. You guys ever watch that movie Idiocracy? I feel like that movie's playing out in like real life. Slowly but surely, it's coming. It's coming to fruition. Where's Air Todd so I could tell him I messed up right there? Look, Air Todd, there's a happy little mistake happening right now. There's a happy little mistake. We're gonna turn it into something here in the back. Just bam! See that? Just gave us the nice little waves right there. Simple. It's in the background, so meh. Nobody will ever see that. I'm not gonna focus on that. Yeah, you see Air Todd there? I messed up Air Todd. Look at these lines here. They don't belong, but I've made them work. I should live. I'm gonna do this right here. Oh, now they don't look so bad. It looks good. I can live with it. Yep, that's pretty much right, Kimberly. I like that. This world is a little bit weird. Yeah, I'm completely self-taught. When it comes to airbrushing, I did take art school. Art school. Really? Oh, yeah. I totally went to art school. Bro. I took art class in school, like, in high school. And I say that very loosely because I went to 6 different high schools. And then after all of that, I still ended up just getting a GED because I ended up having to work. And yeah. That's about all I got to say about that. So when I learned how to airbrush, I was really young, for one, you know, so I had that going for me. So I've been airbrushing for a long time. But other than that, yeah, it's been a rough life. Yeah, when it comes to airbrushing, I'm completely self-taught out of a book. Out of multiple books, I guess. From public libraries. I can't even say that I didn't have access to internet. There just plain simply was no internet. I'm not that old, but their internet existed, but there wasn't airbrush material on it. Like, you could... Back then, everybody would use Yahoo. So you could search on Yahoo how to airbrush, and literally nothing would come up. So I learned out of old school books. One of them was red. I know that. It had like a red cover, like that cloth cover kind. It was cool. Man, how could you go to school and not graduate? I wish I would have had the opportunity to finish both high school and college and everything without life being a bitch to me. It would have been amazing. But we all have our own plank to walk, and I'm quite happy where things ended up, so I'm not gonna complain. I think it would have been cool to go to college and... Jeez. I'm the kind of guy, though, that people look at me and they go, "Oh, you learned that in jail?" Nobody ever assumes I went to college anyway, so it's alright. I guess it doesn't really matter. So what did you learn? What did they teach you about airbrushing? Like, what was the... What did you guys use the airbrush for? Back then, it was probably a lot of photo retouching. I say back then like I know, like I know you or something. I don't know. You made it sound like it was a long time ago, so. A lot of surrealism, all right, yeah. Those old school magazine ads. I know what you're talking about. That's pretty cool though. It was fun, but computer made us obsolete. Sounds good. It sounds about right. It sounds like... Honestly, it sounds like you didn't take your skills and apply them to a different field. Because if you were doing your surrealism art, or like your airbrush art, and then that kind of stopped happening, you could have taken that. And then you could have been like, I'm going to do motorcycles now, or I'm going to do this, and I'm going to hold them up to the same standards of airbrushing. It'd have been a rough life, for sure, but you would have advanced motorcycle art in a way, you know, that artists are barely doing today. There are artists that do that. That's basically what they're doing. Because it was never obsolete. I refuse to believe that. No! airbrushing will probably never be obsolete. For the very fact that you can spray over like this right here, like these angles right here, you could get a robot that could spray on flat stuff for sure. You could build a machine, but then when it comes to this, the robot would have to do this and then that. And no doubt, like maybe I guess in another 50 years or something, they'll find a reason to do it. But even then, it would be considered a printer. I wouldn't consider something that a robot does artwork, even if it was AI. I think if it's being done by a robot, it's safe to say that it's pre-programmed, so it's printing it. It's a printer. It's a high-tech printer, but it'd be a printer. Yeah, like in the movie I, Robot, you know, where he draws that thing, but it was programmed into his brain. So you always will need artists. Always. To be honest, if you really think about it, once we make everything into a machine and make it automated, which that seems to be on the route that we're on, but once we do that to everything, the only thing that will be left to do is to do art. You know, people are just gonna have all the time in the world to be creative and build stuff and make stuff and use their robots or whatever to be creative. What's up, George? At least you'd hope that's what people do. But also people just turning into vegetables on their couch. Some shit. Again, I forget not everybody is like me. Thank you.
farm? You have a farm? That's cool. I could be like you if I wasn't sitting on the couch and watching you. Yeah, like, I have no problem with people relaxing, bro. Like, if you had a long day at work, you know, whatever. Or if you just had a long week and maybe you just want to have a day off. Or you've had a few months, you know, whatever. And you just need a day or two to recoup. That's cool. But I think some people take that and run with it, bro. Some people is like months worth of sitting on the couch. Not doing nothing. I mean, right now, I guess it's hard to say that because a lot of people are not working and stuff like that, but I know even after the country reopens, bro, a lot of people are still going to be at home. Wait, what the hell am I talking about? I'm at home. Wait, what? What was it talking about? Ghosted in the back, kind of dark, so that we can have that kind of in the forefront right there. What's up, RC Room? Yeah, that's kind of the point why we're putting all the work into this bike. I plan to make it say, you know, mikesbrush.com somewhere. So he doesn't have to answer too many questions, but the owner of this bike, he's pretty popular here in town, and he kind of rides it around. Like, he has another bike already, and, you know, I'm sure he'll ride it around everywhere and stuff and show it off, so making sure to do a really nice job. Not only that, but he was kind of like, I just want Aztec stuff. Do what you want. Here's my budget. And, you know, make it look good. And I was just like, all right, that sounds like right up my alley. Let's make it happen. And now we're making it happen. Here, let me, I'm going to try to, if I don't drop everything, I'm going to try to put them both up here and get a picture. I tried. So yeah, we'll show them off one at a time. So first we did this one today, right? And obviously this one has the top. You see with the girl. And then on the side, now we have Mr. Aztec. And let me get it there. there. There you go. So there's that one. Yeah, I just went on Google and Googled some pictures. The owner of the bike sent me some stuff, and we kind of, you know, I went off of his ideas and found some pictures I liked. So there's that one. And on this box, we have the top that has the Aztec sun. And then on the side, we have Quetzalcoatl right there on the side. That one looks cool because it's like, it looks like it's shooting out of it. There you go. That's today's stream. Take the money shot for the screen, for the, you know, for the thumbnail. Cool. Sweet, sweet, sweet. So I will be back on Monday. We'll be back with some more Aztec stuff on Monday. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to do these backs or not, or if we're going to put something else on there. But on Monday, I'll either come back with the backs and the oil covers. But I know for sure the oil covers need to get done, and the tank needs to get, and the fairing needs to get done. So probably the oil covers and these backs on Monday. And then the day after we'll do the tank, and then I'll have to finish up the fairing outside, because, yeah, and then we'll post up the finished pictures for everybody to see. As always, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you click that like button. Make sure you subscribe. As always, if you want to see more videos like this, and if you enjoy these videos, you can always become a member of the Skull Squad, like the people over on YouTube that have the nice skulls next to the name. It helps the channel bring you more videos like this, you know, and yeah, as always, make sure you check out mikesbrush.com. Make sure you go and share some love to Createx Colors for, you know, providing us with lots of paint here on the channel. What else? Yeah, thank you to all the Skull Squad for showing up today. Eric Todd, Dennis, Justice, James, who else showed up today? I don't remember. I think that's it. I know Heather's part of the Skull Squad, Bill's part of the Skull Squad. There's quite a few people who are part of the Skull Squad. Yeah. So yeah, thank you again. Thank you, Eric Todd. See you guys on Monday. Have a happy Father's Day, everybody. I hope everybody enjoys their rest of their weekend. And yeah, we'll see you guys on Monday. Later.